Hi, this is Ajay Singh Patil from Ajay English Word, and you're watching SSC Special Playlist. Dear friends, it was the demand of my viewers to make videos for the 9th and 10th standard students. Here I'm introducing a playlist, SSC Special, where I would like to post the videos for the students of 9th and 10th standard for English subject higher level. In this video, I am trying to introduce you the question paper pattern for the annual examination for 9th and 10th standard students. Dear friends, if you ask me, is it really necessary to know the pattern of question paper? Then my answer will be yes. Then you will ask, why is this necessary and what are the benefits of this to me as a student? Just wait. I would like to explain in detail why and how it is beneficial for you to know the pattern of question paper.
Question paper pattern. The benefits of knowing question paper pattern. It helps to boost your confidence. It helps to cover your paper in time. It helps you to increase your 20% of marks. It works as a guideline while studying the subject. It helps to increase the accuracy of answers. Part 1. State Board of Maharashtra, new format of activity sheet for English higher level. Here is a question paper pattern with full analysis. The question paper will be divided into 6 sections, and these sections will be on language study, textual passage, poetry, non-textual passage, writing skill, and creative writing. Let's understand in detail. Section number 1 will be on language study and it will be for 20 marks. Section number 2, it will be on textual passages. It will be for 20 marks. Section number 3 will be on poetry. It will be for 15 marks. Section number 4, it will be on non-textual passage. It will be for 15 marks. Section number 5, it will be on writing skill and it will be for 20 marks. And section number 6, it will be on creative writing and it will be for 10 marks. Here I would like to explain how much time you can spend on every section. Friends, you can give 25 minutes for section number 1. You can spend 30 minutes for section 2. You can spend 25 minutes on section number 3. You can give 30 minutes to section number 4. You can give 40 minutes for section number 5. And you can spend 20 minutes for section number 6. You should give 10 minutes for review of solve activity sheet. The written activity sheet will be of total 100 marks. The difficulty wise distribution of marks in 100 marks activity sheet will be, there will be 40 marks easy questions. There will be medium range questions for 40 marks. And there will be challenging questions for 20 marks. Section number 1, language study, it will be for 20 marks. The language study section is divided into 2 parts, question number 1A and question number 1B. In question number 1A, there will be 2 sections. A1, there will be simple activities, it will be for 8 marks, and in A2, there will be medium level activities, it will be for 8 marks. And question number 1B part, it will be a set of challenging activities and it will be for 4 marks. Let's understand in details. Question number 1A. A1 language study. There will be simple activities for 8 marks. There will be 8 simple activities carrying 1 mark each. They will be based on various questions like, write 2 compound words of your own. Pick out an infinitive, gerund, present participle and use in your own sentence. Punctuate the following. Use of quotation marks, commas, apostrophe, capitalization, full stop, question mark and exclamation mark. Finding out hidden words from the given word. Make a meaningful sentence by using the given phrase. Spot the error and rewrite the correct sentence using the correct verb form, subject, verb, agreement. To be's verb, to do's verb, to has verb, third person and singular. Identify the types of sentences. Complete the word chain of nouns, verbs, adjectives. For example, cricket. In this word, last letter is T. So you have to start new word with T. So I have started team word is there. And the last letter of team is M. So next word will be started with M. In a such way, at least 4 words are expected to be in your word chain. Arrange the following words in alphabetical order. Form present participle, past participle in which the last letter is doubled. For example, plan, planning, plan. Plant. Question number 1A, A2 language study. There will be middle level activities. It will be for 8 marks. And in these activities, you have to select at least 4 medium level activities may be selected from those listed below. Each carries 2 marks. Question number 1A, A2, language study. There will be middle level activities. Any 4 medium level activities may be selected from those listed below. Each activity carries 2 marks. These activities will be based on various questions like make sentences of your own to show difference of the homograph, homonyms in meaning. For example, homograph, bat, B-A-T, bat. It is a piece sporting equipment. The another word, B-A-T, bat, is a kind of bird. Homophone, peace, P-E-A-C-E. Peace means the general security of public places. And another word is there, P-I-E-C-E, peace, means a portion of an object. Dear friends, homograph means the spelling is same, the pronunciation is also same, but the meaning is different. And homophones means the pronunciation of the word is same, but the spelling is different and meaning is different. Direct and indirect narration. Any kind of sentence from direct and indirect. Conversion of tenses. Change the voice by giving object or subject. Word register. 8 words related to given subject. Be part of question 1 of language study section. There will be challenging activities for 4 marks. Any 2 challenging activities may be selected from those listed below. Each activity carries 2 marks. These activities will be based on various questions like use of same given words as a noun as well as a verb in sentences. For example, ban. Change the degree of comparison. Underline the modal auxiliary and state its function. Analyze the sentence. Simple, complex, compound. Use the given 2 words in 1 meaningful sentence. note. Dear friends, some more activities might be added by the teachers as per the requirement of the students. Section number 2, it will be on textual passages and it will be for 20 marks. Dear friends, your reading skill, vocabulary and grammar will be tested under this section. Under this section, false question number 2. A. Read the following passage and complete the activities. It will be for 10 marks. Question number 2. B. Read the following passage and complete the activities. It will be for 10 marks. Question number 2A and question number 2B are from the prose lessons in the textbook. Each question carries a total of 10 marks. Each question has 5 activities of 2 marks each. Dear friends, you can give 30 minutes for this section. Now, let's understand question number 2A in details, which kind of activity you can face. Dear friends, A1 will be simple factual activity carrying 2 marks. This activity will be of objective type, such as fill in the blanks, choose the correct alternative, true or false, match the columns, name the following, etc. This activity may also include a web or a table to be completed. Answer can be picked up directly from the given passage. A2 will be complex factual activity carrying 2 marks. This activity is based on more than one part of the passage. It will be activity based or information transfer. It will be in the format of complete the following web, table, tree diagram, etc. It could also be in the form of a question, WS question. A3 will be vocabulary based activity carrying 2 marks. This activity too will be based on the passage. It will include meanings of the words, phrases, opposites, similar sounding words, framing or completing sentences, table, etc. A4 will be activity based on contextual grammar carrying 2 marks. This activity test your grammar skill. One or two grammar activities based on the passage will be asked. A5 will be an activity based on personal response, expression, creation and imagination carrying 2 marks. This activity may ask for your personal opinion or views on the issues that arise out of the passage. And dear friends, you can give 15 minutes for this paragraph. Question number 2B. Read the following passage and complete the activities. It will be for 10 marks. Dear friends, let's understand which type of activity will be asked under this paragraph. B1. Simple factual activity carrying 2 marks. This activity will be of objective type, such as fill in the blanks, choose the correct alternative, true or false, match the columns, name the followings, etc. This activity may also include a web or a table to be completed. Answer can be picked up directly from the given passage. B2. Complex factual activity carrying 2 marks. This activity is based on more than one part of the passage. It will be activity based or information transfer. For example, it will be in the format of complete the following web, table, tree diagram, etc. It could also be in the form of a question. B3 will be vocabulary-based activity carrying 2 marks. This activity 2 will be based on the passage. It will include meanings of the words, phrases, opposites, similar sounding words, framing or completing sentences, tables, etc. B4 will be activity based on contextual grammar carrying 2 marks. This activity tests your grammar skill. 1 or 2 grammar activities based on the passage will be asked. B5 will be an activity based on personal response, expression, creation, imagination, carrying 2 marks. This activity may ask for your personal opinion or views on the issues that arise out of the passage. Dear friends, you can give 15 minutes for this paragraph. Section number 3, poetry. It will be for 15 marks. Dear friends, under this section, your comprehension skill for a poem is tested. Question number 3 falls under this section and there are 2 parts in question number 3, A and B. Question number 3A and question number 3B are from the poetry in the textbook. Question number 3A is for a comprehension having 3 activities carrying 5 marks in all. Question number 3B is for appreciation of a poem. It will be for 10 marks. Both questions carry a total of 15 marks. Dear friends, students should write an appreciation of the given poem with the help of given points in a paragraph format. And friends, you have to give for this question 30 minutes. Let's understand in detail question number 3A. Question number 3A. Read the following extract and complete the activities. A1 will be simple factual activity carrying 2 marks. This activity will be of objective type like true or false, complete the following, etc. Or an information transfer question. For example, in the format of a web, table, T-diagram, etc. A2 will be complex factual activity carrying 2 marks. This question may be based on more than one part of the extract or may require a long answer of more than one sentence. This can be in the form of a WH question. Activity A3 will be an activity based on poetic device. This activity tests various aspects of poetry such as poetic language, rhyming words, rhyming scheme, figure of speech, etc. This activity 2 will be of the objective type and it will be for 1 mark. And dear friends, you have to give total of 15 minutes for this question A. Dear friends, you can give 15 minutes for this question. Question number 3B. Read the following poem and write an appreciation of it with the help of the given points in a paragraph format. This question will be for 10 marks. Let me explain in detail the marking scheme for every point. You will get 1 mark for the title of the poem. You will get 1 mark for the name of the poet. There will be 2 marks for the theme or central idea. At least 2 or 3 lines are expected. You will get 1 mark for rhyming scheme. There will be 1 mark for the figure of speech. Any one of the figure of speech from the poem you can write. There will be 2 marks for special features. Under this point, you can write type of the poem, imagery, implied meaning of any, etc. And at least 5 to 6 lines are expected under this point. There will be one mark for favorite line or lines. You can write at least two lines. There will be one mark for why I like the poem or why I don't like the poem. Dear friends, you can give 15 minutes for this question.
Don't forget to watch part 2, which is coming soon.